How many people in this audience believe in the idea that the way you think has some effect on your life? That your thoughts are intimately connected to your future? How many people think that? So your thoughts in some way create your reality. You believe that? You see, you think 60,000 to 70,000 thoughts in one day. Out of those 60,000 to 70,000 thoughts that you think in one day, 90% of those thoughts are the same thoughts as the day before. So if you believe that your thoughts somehow are connected to your life, then the same thoughts always lead to the same choices. The same choices always lead to the same behaviors. The same behaviors create the same experiences, and the same experiences produce the same emotions. And those very same emotions drive the very same thoughts. And your biology, your neurocircuitry, your neurochemistry, your neurohormones, and even your genetic expression is equal to how you think, how you act, and how you feel. So then how do people change? They wait for crisis, trauma, disease, diagnosis, loss. Something has to go wrong in their life where they feel so uncomfortable that they finally make up their mind to change. And why is that? You can learn and change in a state of pain and suffering, or you can learn and change in a state of joy and inspiration. To change, to truly change, is to think greater than your environment, to think greater than the circumstances in your life, to think greater than the conditions in your world. And every great person in history knew this. Can you believe in a future that you can't see or experience with your senses yet, but you've thought about enough times in your mind that your brain is literally changed to look like the event has already occurred? The latest research in neuroscience says you can change your brain from living in the past to living in the future. And can you fall in love with that vision to such a degree that you come out of your resting state and change guilt or suffering into inspiration and joy and gratitude? To such a degree that your body, as the unconscious mind, does not know the difference between that external event and what you're creating internally? So that your body believes it's living in that future in the present moment, and you begin to signal new genes in new ways to change your body to look like the event has already occurred. The latest research in epigenetics says you can change your body by thought alone. Now reason this with me. If there's physical evidence in your brain and body to look like the event has already occurred, your brain and body are no longer living in the past, they're living in the future. And you will walk right into your vision.